students, I am Shaista, your mathematics teacher. Today I am going to teach you mathematics part 2, basic proportionality theorem. Basic proportionality theorem was introduced by a famous Greek mathematician Thales, hence it is also called as Thales theorem. Now my dear students, let us understand basic proportionality theorem in detail. So here the theorem is, if a line parallel to a side of a triangle intersect the remaining side in two distinct points, then the line divides the side in the same proportion. Here triangle ABC, line L parallel to line BC. Okay, this line L parallel to line BC, and here P and Q is the intersection point. Okay, inside here P point P and point Q is the intersection point of triangle ABC. So here we will write, given triangle ABC, line L parallel to line BC and line L intersect AB and AC in point P and Q respectively. After this we have to prove here AP upon PB that is equal to AQ upon QC. Here we will construct segment PC and segment BQ. Just draw PC and BQ. After this, proof triangle APQ and triangle PQB have common height QR. After this, here therefore triangle APQ upon triangle PQB that is equal to AP upon PB. Step 1. Triangles having equal height, here you can see this triangle having equal height, and in triangle APQ and triangle PQC have common height, that is PS. Therefore triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQC that is equal to AQ upon QC. Triangle having equal heights, here triangle having equal heights. So after this, here you can see this triangle, so here segment PQ is the common base. Here segment PQ is the common base of triangle PQB and PQC. Of triangle PQB and PQC, PQ is the common base. Therefore segment PQ parallel to segment BC have, hence triangle PQB and triangle PQC have equal heights. Okay, here triangle PQB and PQC have equal height. Okay, after this we will write here area of triangle PQB that is equal to area of triangle PQC, step number 3. After this, here they both are equal, so we will write here area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQB that is equal to area of triangle APQ upon area of triangle PQC. Now my dear students, here on this step we will write here from 1 and 2 and 3. This step we get from 1, 2 and 3. Okay, here AP upon, here hence we prove that AP upon PB that is equal to AQ upon QC from first and second. Hence we prove this, that they both are proportion. So simple and easy to understand. After understanding basic proportionality theorem, now let's solve converse of basic proportionality theorem. Here, converse of basic proportionality theorem says that if the line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. Here, triangle ABC. Here, triangle ABC, line L. This line L is dividing. Okay. Two distinct point, it means A and B. Okay, so here line PQ parallel to line BC, and here AP upon PB that is equal to AQ upon QC. Then we have to prove that, then we have to show here PQ parallel to BC. Then we have to show here PQ parallel to BC. So here in triangle ABC, PQ parallel to BC, and we have to here AP upon BP that is equal to AQ upon QC. We have to show here proportionality. So here in triangle ABC, AP upon B,
PB is equal to AQ upon QC. To prove, we have to prove here segment PQ parallel to segment BC. Okay, construction is this PT. So assume that PT parallel to BC. Assume that PT parallel to BC. Proof, what we have to prove here? Segment PT parallel to BC by construction. Okay, so this, after this, AP upon PB is equal to AT upon TC. This PT we have assumed, that we have considered here. So point number one, BPT theorem, basic proportionality theorem. But AP upon PB, that is equal to AQ upon QC, is the given part which is there in your question. So here AP upon PB, that is equal to AP upon PB, they both are equal. That means first point and second point, LHS and RHS are equal. AT upon TQ and AQ upon QC. So from 1 and 2 we get here AT upon TC, that is equal to AQ upon QC. Okay, so here on this step, AT upon TC, that is equal to AQ upon QC. So AT upon TC plus 1 is equal to AQ upon QC plus 1. Okay, we have to add here 1. Okay, why? Because they are common. So AT upon TC is equal to AQ upon QC plus QC upon QC. So here AC upon TC is equal to AQ upon QC. Okay, so here AC upon QC, QQ get cancelled and TT get cancelled. So AC upon TC is equal to AC upon QC. So AC get cancelled, we get here QC is equal to TC. So point T and point Q are coincide, so that point T and point Q are not different. They are not different. They are similar point. So segment PT and segment PQ are the same segment. Similar segment. PT and PQ are same segment. So segment PQ congruent to segment BC. Hence proved. We have proved that PQ parallel to BC. So simple and easy to solve. Converse basic proportionality theorem. Yes, my dear students. Welcome to maths class. In this video, you are going to learn about practice set 1.2. Before solving practice set 1.2, let us understand basic proportionality theorem and converse basic proportionality theorem. Remember this, basic proportionality theorem, in this triangle ABC, okay, this PQ is the intersection line. Okay, so here if a line parallel to a side of a triangle intersect the remaining side in two distinct points, then the line divides the side in the same proportion. So this is a basic proportion theorem where line AC parallel to PQ. Okay, PQ and AC are parallel line, and here PQ is the intersection line of AB and AC. So in triangle ABC, if segment PQ parallel to segment AC, then AP upon BP is equal to QC upon BQ. Is that clear? So this we have to prove when we are solving basic proportionality theorem. This we have already solved, okay, in detail. I have made one video of this. So converse basic proportionality theorem. Here, if a line divide any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. And that means here, triangle PQR. Here in triangle PQR, okay, ST parallel to QR, okay, in triangle PQR, ST parallel to QR, and if PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR, okay, then we have to prove segment ST parallel to QR. This we have to prove here, okay. If PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR is there, then we have to prove segment ST parallel to QR. Now remember this, angle bisector triangle. Okay, so here we will see study property of an angle bisector triangle. Third property of an angle bisector of a triangle says that triangle ABC, here the bisector of an angle of a triangle divide the side opposite to the angle in the ratio of the remaining sides. In triangle ABC, BD is the bisector. Here you can see in triangle ABC, BD is the bisector. So here we will write, if BD is the bisector of angle ABC, then we have to prove that AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DC. This we have to prove here. Okay, now we'll see four property. And converse of angle bisector of an angle of a triangle theorem. So in triangle ABC, if AB upon BC, that is equal to AD upon DC. Okay, so then here BD is bisector of angle ABC. Now students, let's study about property of three parallel line and their transversal. Here, property of three parallel line and their transversal: AX parallel to line BY parallel to line CZ, and here line L and M are their transversal. Then we have to prove here that AB upon BC, that is equal to XY upon YZ. Okay, this we have to prove this. So AB upon BC, that is equal to XY upon YZ. We have to calculate here its proportionality. Okay, so yes, this is the property of three parallel line and their transversal. Now my dear students, let's solve practice set 1.2 on the base of this basic concept. So here question number 1 says that given below are some triangles and lengths of line segments. Identify which figures rapium is the bisector of angle QPR. Okay, so here we are solving sub-question 1. So here you can see this QPR, and here sides are also given. So first sub-question says that solution in triangle PQR. Okay, so first we will write the given value. PQ is equal to 7, PR is equal to 3, QM is equal to 3.5, and MR is equal to 1.5. After this, here we are going to find this rapium. Okay, this we have to find here. So one by one we will see this. So first we have to write here given part, and after that we have to find the value. So here we will put the value like proportionality, PQ upon PR, that is equal to 7 upon 3. Okay, so here this first step. Now QM upon MR, that is equal to 3.5 upon 1.5. Now 1.5 ones and 3.5 multiplied by 2, and 1.5 multiplied by 2, that is equal to 7 upon 3. See this proportionality, both are equal. Here 3.5 is multiplying by 2, then only we get here 7, and 1.5 multiplied by 2, then we get here 3. For this proportionality, we are taking here from 1 and 2, PQ upon QR, PQ upon PR, that is equal to QM upon MR. Okay, so from 1 and 2, from left hand side, that is equal to right hand side. So rapium is the bisector of angle QPR. Is that clear, my dear friends? So simple and easy to solve sub question 1. Now let's solve sub question 2. Here sub question 2 says that in triangle PQR, PQ is equal to 10, PR is equal to 7, QM is equal to 8, and MR is equal to 6. Okay, and we have to find rapium is the bisector. As you can see here, PM is the bisector. So this we have to prove. So first we will write here PQ upon PR, that is equal to 10 upon 7. After this we will write here this first step number 1. Now here QM upon MR, that is 8 upon 6. As you can see, they both are not equal. Okay, so here 2 3s are 6 and 2 4s are 8. So here we get 4 upon 3. Okay, after dividing we get here 4 upon 3, step number 2. And they both are not equal, that means left hand side and right hand side are not equal. PQ from 1 and 2, here we get PQ upon PR is not equal to QM upon MR. Okay, that means left hand side is not equal to right hand side. So ray PM is not the bisector of angle QPR. Is that clear? So simple and easy to solve sub question 2. Now let's solve sub question 3. In triangle PQR, PQ is equal to 9, PR is equal to 10, QM is equal to 3.6 and MR is equal to 4. And we have to prove that whether AM is ray PM is bisector or not. So PQ upon PR is equal to 9 upon 10. After this we will write here step number 1. Now QM upon MR, that is equal to 3.6 upon 4. So here decimal point is there, that means we will multiply by 10. So 3.6 multiply by 10 36 and 4 multiply by 10 40. So here 9's are and 10's are, 4 9's are 36 and 4 10's are 40. So 9 upon 10. So here step number 2 we get 9 upon 10. So from first and second step we get LH is equal to RHS. So PQ upon PR is equal to QM upon MR. That means LHS equal to RHS. Here PM is the bisector. Ray PM is the bisector of angle QPR because they are equal. Is that clear? So simple and easy to solve. Now let's solve question number 2. In triangle PQR, PM is equal to 15, PQ is equal to 25, PR is equal to 20, NR is equal to 8. State whether line NM is parallel to side RQ. Give reason. So here we will apply the property. Okay. So as question says that here in triangle PQR, value of PM, okay, is 15. So first we will write in triangle PQR. PM is equal, first we will write given PM is equal to 15, PQ is equal to 25, PR is equal to 20, NR is equal to 8. After this, see here PQ is 25 and PR is 20. PQ is 25. Okay, so and NR is 8. So one by one we will write here. So MQ is equal to PQ minus PM. So 25 minus 15 is 10. So here we found MQ is 10. Is that clear? So now PN is equal to PR minus NR. So 20 minus 8 is 12. So PN is equal to 12. So simple. After this, now PN upon NR, that is equal to 12 upon 8. Okay, so 4 3 is 12, 4 2 is 8, that is equal to 3 upon 2. After this, here step number 1. Now PM upon MQ, that is equal to 15 upon 10, 5 2 is 10, 5 3 is 15, again 3 upon 2. So here 3 upon 2, so this 3 upon 2 is equal to 3 upon 2. So from first and second we get PN upon NR equal to PM upon MQ. They both are equal, that means left hand side equal to right hand side, converse of BPT, line NM is parallel to side RQ. So simple. After applying converse theorem we get answer. Now let's solve question number 3. In triangle MNP, NQ is bisector of angle N. If MN is equal to 5, PN is equal to 7, MQ is equal to 2.5, then find QR. So here we will apply bisector property. In triangle MNP, NQ is the bisector of angle N, MN is equal to 5, PN is equal to 7, MQ is equal to 2.5 and QP we have to find. So MN upon PN, that is equal to 5 upon M, that is equal to MQ upon QP. So here property of angle bisector, okay, property of angle bisector. So here 5 upon 7 left hand side, MQ upon QP, we have MQ is 2.5 but we don't know the value of QP. We are finding this value. So QP multiply by 5 equal to 2.5 multiply by 7. Now keep QP on left hand side, 2.5 multiply by 7 upon 5. So here 5 2s are and 2 here 7. Okay, so 2.5 1s are and 2.5 2s are 5. So here 7 upon 2. After dividing this, we get 3.5. So QP is 3.5. So simple and easy to solve. Yes, my dear students. As you know that 2.5 1s are 2.5 and 2.5 2s are is 5. So 7 1s are 7 and here denominator is 2, so 7 upon 2. So answer after dividing this 7 by 2, we get here 3.5. That means QP is equal to 3.5. Students, your task is to solve practice set 1.2 in your Maths 2 notebook. And if you find any difficulty, any doubt in any particular question, you can contact me. Thank you for watching my video. Enjoy learning.